So for today, I'll not be discussing with a very technical point of view. Just I'll be giving an overview of what exactly mean by this RPA and how exactly our training will be done on the RPA here. Okay, let's understand now. The very first thing, if I'm talking about the SDLC, so if you take any software development lifecycle, previously, if I'm taking with the process, we used to be having mainly two things. One will be taking with the development, and the one will be taking with the testing. If you take any of our software projects, first it need to be get developed with the help of the developers. Once development part has been completed, then it will be moving into the testing activity to take with the testing. And again, if I'm taking with the testing, and the testing will be taking with the two things. One will be taking with the manual testing, and one will be taking with the automation testing. Right? So if you understand it, and the testing we are getting with the two things. One we are mentioning that manual testing, and one we will be mentioning the automation testing. Manual testing, which it need to be done manually. That means we have to be open our application, we have to be enter the username, we have to be enter the password, clicking on the login button. Everything need to be done manually only. Okay. So if you want to be done manually, as it is taking with the more time, it has been moved into the automation testing. Coming to automation testing, we are mentioning that testing done by the tool. Like we can take any automation tool, it may be Selenium, it may be QTP, it may be RFP, any automation tool we can use it and we can get implemented automation testing. If you understand it, in a market, already we are having with the automation testing. But nowadays, we are hearing about with the new word that is called as a RPA. Previously, most of the market is working with the automation testing only. But now, we are hearing with the one more word that we are taking with the RPA. So what exactly mean by this RPA? What make the difference of this automation testing and what exactly this RPA? Okay, let's understand on it. If I'm taking with the RPA, which I will be mentioning that robotic process automation. If I'm taking with the word of RPA, mentioning that the robotic process automation. Here also we are mentioning that automation, and here also we are mentioning that automation. Then what makes the exact difference? If I'm talking about testing point of view, so now if I'm taking with this automation, robotic process automation, here we are mentioning that automation, and here also we are mentioning with the automation. Then what exactly makes the difference? If you're talking about testing point of view, we are doing automation. So if I'm talking about with the testing point of view, we are doing with the automation. This automation is related to functionality. It means you are getting automated application functionality. Whether application functionality is working fine or not, that is what they will be taking with the automation. But coming to the RPA, we are doing the automation only, but not like focused to the functionality. We are mainly focusing to the process. Here we are doing the automation that is related to the functionality. Here we are doing with the automation that is related to the process. Okay. And now you can see the specific word mentioning as a robotic. Till now, if I'm taking any automation tools, it is not mentioning as a robotic. But here specifically it is mentioning with the robot. The reason is The reason it was mentioned as the robotic is, for example, if I'm taking it as one human being, whatever the activities he was doing, the same activities will be done with the help of the one robot. That robot is nothing but, according to our real-time terminology, we are calling as a one bot. If I'm taking with the bot, one bot is considered as a one robot, or you can consider, like in our understanding, we can take one system. One system can be considered as a one bot. At the same time, in one system, we can create with the multiple bots also. So one bot is equal to one resource. Okay, understand that? One bot is equal to one resource. So one human being, nothing but one resource, whatever the work he was doing it, the same work will be done by the bot. So if you understand the major difference, in the testing activities you were doing with the testing, that is functionality, but here you will be taking negative testing, positive testing, system testing, lot of testing activities you will be doing. But here we are taking one process and we are getting automated that process with the help of the one robot. That what I will be taking with the robotic process automation. Now, what exactly mean by this process? Take an example of the some projects. Take an example of the BPO projects or data entry projects. Take an example of the data entry projects. Assume that we have one company is there, data entry company is there. The company is maintaining with the 20 employees. If I am taking with the 20 employees, what their exactly role of the employees? They have to be come to the office, opening with the Excel file, copying the data from Excel file. The data need to be entered into application, then make some validations, and then extract into the report. If I am taking with the role of the employee, each and every employee, what exactly they are doing? Coming to the office and then opening the Excel file, copy the data from Excel, enter into the application, meet with the validation, and they are extracting with the report. If you understand, these guys are not doing the testing here. These guys are not doing any testing. They are taking the data from Excel file, entering into the application, and then generating a report. This is one process they are doing. Now, what exactly RPA is mentioning is, assume that you are maintaining with the 20 employees for doing with the data entry. Rather than maintaining with the 20 employees, maintain only 10 employees only and replace remaining 10 employees with my bot. You can create 10 bots, 10 employees will get replaced. So 10 bots, you can create in one system or you can maintain with the 10 system, that according to that. Now what exactly these 10 employees are doing it? The same activity my bot will be doing it. What my bot will be doing? It will open the Excel file. It will take the data from Excel and then enter into the application. It will do the validation and then it will be generating the report. So previously you were spending with the budget for 20 resources. Now you are spending with the budget only for 10 resources. So if I'm taking with the data entry, now, rather than maintaining the 20 employees, we can replace with the 10 employees with my bot. So that means you are reducing with the employee count here. So by that you can save your budget here. So that was the main objective of the RPA. So one example I've been taken with the data entry. Take an example of the BPO. If I am taking with the BPO, majorly will be having with the two kinds of jobs will be there. One will be voice related, another one is non-voice related. If I am taking with the role of the non-voice related BPO jobs, what exactly they will be doing? They will be going to the office and the people will be asking with the questions in a chat and they have to be reviewed. That means the person has to be replied to the job. Right. Now, let's take one real-time example. So, recently this HDFC bank has been implemented this RPA technology. Okay. So, how exactly it will be working is, if I'm taking with the HDFC bank. Now, what exactly this bank has been done is, previously they are maintaining with the employees for replying with the chart here. Now, rather than maintaining with the employees, they got implementing with the bot here. In a place of resource, they have been implemented with the bot. You can see here. You are able to see with the ask you. If I am clicking on it, now we can see what exactly it is doing. It is clearly mentioning that my name is Eva and I am in a chatbot. You can see here. If you look into the name, it is clearly mentioning with the chatbot here. So this is one bot. Now we can see here. I'll be typing an as a IFC code. I can see what it is asking. Please provide the name of the branch. Now if you understand it, there is no person here. There is no human being. My bot is replying it here. I'll be typing yes. Then it is giving it the list of the IFC code. Then I'll be typing as branch address. Please provide the name of the branch. I'll be typing this. You can understand the concept of the RPA here. Okay. Now if you see here, there is no employees there. My bot is replying for all my questions here. Right. So this what exactly the RPA will be doing it here. So it will be taking one process. For example, you are typing some invalid address here. Okay. So for example, I will be giving in some invalid address. For example, I am giving HYD. I can see here. I did not understand you properly. That means whatever the process we got created, whatever the things we have been provided, it will be giving the correct details related to that. Okay. So that what the RPA has been came into the picture. So if I am taking RPA, it is automation only, but not like any functionality automation. It is like any process automation. If I am taking this process, it may be related to data entry, it may be related to BPO, it may be related to the bank, it may be related to the hospitality domain, it may be related to the supply management, anything. So any way we can get implemented this RPA. Okay, so this what exactly mean by this RPA will make it the difference between other automation tools and then RPA automation tools. Okay, and moreover, what exactly make you some other differences? If I'm taking with the automation tools, for example, take with the Selenium, we need to be have a knowledge of the Java program. If I'm taking QTP, we require with the knowledge of the VB script. If you want to be work with any automation tool, it is mandatory that we require some basic programming knowledge. But coming to the RPA, there is no concept of the programming knowledge. To work with any automation tool, we doesn't require any programming knowledge. If I am taking with the RPA, under RPA, we are having different tools out there. One you will be taking with the Blue Prism. Okay. And the one you will be mentioning with the automation anywhere. Okay. And one you will be mentioning with the OpenStack. Okay. And one you will be taking with the WorkVision. And one you will be mentioning with the UI. So these are the major tools the market has been occupied with the RPA. If I am comparing these tools also, the major market has been occupied with these tools. Blue Prism and automation. Previously, major market has been occupied with automation anywhere only. But now, slowly the market is moving into the automation. Sorry, Blue Prism. If I am taking an example of the Citibank, previously Citibank got implemented, they bought in automation anywhere too. But now they are getting some production issues. Because of that, it has been moving into the blue prism. Now the Citibank is migrating from automation layer to the blue prism. So if you understand with the market, the major market is moving into the blue prism and automation layer. Now, you will be having in a doubt, do we need to be learned with all automation tools? I mean, all RPA tools? No. For getting started in your career or for changing your job, any one tool will be the enough. In case if the people are interested, we can go with the multiple things, but any one tool will be the more enough. Either we can go with the blue prism or we can go with the automation anywhere. Okay. Now, coming to our training, I'll be getting trained on the blue prism only, not with the automation anywhere. So I'll be providing with the clear details about with the blue prism. Now, to learn with the blue prism, any prerequisite out there. So to learn with the blue prism, there is no prerequisite here. It is totally code free tool. You doesn't require any coding knowledge for learning with the blue prism tool. Okay. It is just a drag and drop only, not like any writing any of the code. In case, assume that you have any requirement to write in a code. 95% they will not be using with the code, but in case of 5%, if you want to be use any code, then we are having with the option for writing with the code also. But 95% of the time we will not be getting any chance. But in case if required, that option is also provided in blue prism. Okay. And any freshers can learn it, any experienced guys can learn it, any graduate can learn it. It may be MBA or it may be BTech or any BTech, any branch or any normal degree person. Anyone can learn with the blue prism. But only the thing we need to be cross-check it out is, in case if the people is having with the more gap, we cannot fill all the gap into the blue prism. That means, assume that you are having the 3 years gap is there, but we cannot say that I am having 3 years experience in blue prism. Maximum will be suggesting with only 1 year only. But in case if required, we can plan for the 2 years, but not like more than 2 years. Okay. Now, in blue prism, what exactly will be getting trained here? So first you will be understanding about with the blue prism introduction. Okay. So we'll be understanding with the blue prism introduction. That means this is what my blue prism tool here. These are the different tabs you will be having. So we will be getting understanding in a very detailed about what is the purpose of each and every tab. First we will be understanding that what is the purpose of each and everything. We will be discussing individually. After that I will be taking with the integration. That means how exactly we can connect from one process to another process. So we will be getting started from very basic level. And they will be learning up to the advanced level. So this is what exactly I'll be getting trained on the each and every topic here. Okay. Next. They will be understanding about with the tool installation process. Okay. So for installing with the tool, we already know that this is the license, not taking a freeware here. Okay. So I'll be giving with the one crack license also. I'll be providing with the license file. So you can get installed in your system by that continuously in work with the blue prism. How exactly the installation process need to be done, I'll be sharing with the document, and at the same time I'll be explaining it how exactly the tool need to be get installed. Next, we'll be discussing about with the stages. Stages are nothing but commands. For example, if I'm taking any other automation tools, if you want to be open any application, you will be taking one command. If you want to be typing a data into the text box, you will take with the command of type. If you want to be close any application, you will be taking with the command of close. Similar to that, how we are working with the commands in other automation tool, here we will be working with the stages. If you see here, let me take one stage. Now this is what the UI of the tool will be having it. This is where you will be writing with the coding control. Assume that you want to write one condition. There is a built-in statement of decision. Just you will be making with the drag and drop. Here you will be making your decision. You want to write one loop. he will be making with the drag and drop of the loop. He want to be read with the data from the text box. He will be reading with the touch. You want to be write the data into the text box. He will be writing. Everything is a drag and drop only. Nowhere concept of writing any code and everything. Once you have been taken with the drag and drop activity, you have to be made with the link. The only thing, you require some technical knowledge to make with the link activity. So how exactly this link need to be done? That is nothing but how exactly your process has to be working. According to that particular process, you have to be made with the link. You can see I am not writing any code. Everything has been taken with the drag and drop only. So that what we'll be discussing about with the all the stages. Once we are clear about this particular stages, then I'll be discussing about with the one end to end process. Okay, nothing but end to end flow, or you can consider that in the one end to end process. So once we are clear about with the end to end process, that we will be getting with the clear picture of the two. We will be ready for attending with the interviews, and we will be ready for working with the blueprint tool to get automated in the process. But at the same time, apart from these things, we will be discussing about with the concept of surface automation. Okay. The surface automation is nothing but like an related to images. For example, assume that you are having one image. In image, some text is available. You have to read that particular text from the image. This facility is not available in most of the automation tools. But if I am taking with the RPA, we can work with the images or keyboard activities. So we'll be discussing about whether the surface automation. This is like related to the images or which we will be taking with the keyboard activities. Or calling as option of global sending keys. Okay. In BP, in Blue Prism, we are having with the global sending keys option is there. With the help of that, we can perform the keyboard activities. This is also will be getting time. Next, we'll be getting understanding about Windows applications. How we can get automated Windows application. One, we'll be getting time work application. One, we will be getting trained on a Windows application. If required, if the time permit, we'll try to take with the one ERP application also. We'll get automated one ERP application also. By that, we will be getting familiar with three processes. One process is related to web application. One process is related to the Windows application. And one process is related to the ERP applications. Okay. And apart from this, at last, we'll be discussing about the user roles. Okay. User roles is nothing but like a network admin. So, for example, if I'm taking with any of the IT companies, we used to be having a network admin guys will be there. So, their exact role is they need to create with the users. Like for one is admin user and another employee role. For employee role, what are the options need to be displayed in PP? So all those things, you will be having an option under user roles. And then after this, we will be discussing about with the some extra stuff, miscellaneous like working with the word bad, okay. Or we will be discussing about with the scheduling, how we can meet with the scheduling activities. And then once schedule has been completed, how the release will be done. So everything will be getting discussed. So this is what very high level. What exactly will be getting trained under Blue Prism. So I'm getting started with the tool installation, and then I will be taking with the stages, and then I will be taking with the one end-to-end flow, and I will be working with the different applications. All this training, it's not like any theory class, or it's not like in a practical class. It's not like one day theory class, one day practical class. From the day one itself, it will be taking with the project oriented. I'll be taking with the one application. At the same time, I'll be giving the same application for the practice purpose also. So by the whatever the examples I'm discussing in the session, the same thing you can get practice with the application. Okay. From the day one itself, it will be the project oriented only. Not like in some days will be theory class, some days will be practical class. Generally, the people will be making two things. theory classes will be the separate course and then project testing will be the separate course. It's not like that. It will be getting combined in one part only. From day one itself, we'll be taking you to the project testing. We'll be getting started from very basic level and I will be closing with the advanced level. So apart from all these things, we will be getting with the materials. I'll be giving some soft copies. We'll be having it. So soft copies I'll be providing. And in case if you require any help on the resume session or any help in the FAQs, how exactly the questions will be getting. So that kind of things also we'll be discussing. So that's exactly what we will be getting trained in the blue place I'm trying. So any questions from here? So now let me show an example. So let me show you one sample example here. You can see that I've been already created with the one process. If you look into this particular process, just I'm opening one application and then it will wait for some time. It will be typing with the username, typing with the password. Next, it will click on the login button. Once it's clicked on login button, it will take some time to take login. It is selecting with the value from the drop down. After that, it was typing with the employee ID, clicking on the search button. Employee ID will be displayed. It will click on the logout, then closing with the application. Now you can see, I have not written any technical things, no concept of coding and everything. Just everything have been taken with the drag and drop only and have been done with the connectivities. Now we can see how exactly it will run. So to make with the run activity, we will be having this go button. It will be having the option of which speed you have been required, very fast or normal slow. I'll be taking with the normal only. Click on the run button. You can see we're able to see something getting highlighted in our color. Whatever the step it was getting executed, you will be able to see that is moving into the highlighted in yellow color. Now we can see that it will be typing with the username, typing with the password, going with the login. Now it will select the employee ID from the search button. Employee ID code selected. Now it will be typing with the employee ID. Now it will click on search button and then taking with the logo, close application. Now it will be clicking on the logout, then close the application. Complete. So that's what I've been taking on simple process just to make with the login, log activity and searching for employee. So like this, it will be taking with the manual scenarios will be there. I mean, process steps will be there. According to that particular process, it will be getting automated or it will be getting automated with any of the process. So that's exactly the how the tool will be working it and then how we can get executed. Okay.